There's nothing like starting on a recital on full organ. You get the drift when you hear full organ. It's your organ recital. This next piece is a miniature, and as you look at this program and read the descriptions, this is the only miniature on the program. It's a very sweet piece. It started out as a piano piece, and then, of course, Liszt arranged it for organ. And so it really shows the charming, softer stops of the organ. There will be no celeste, no undulating celeste really on this, because the German organs of the 19th century had very few of what we'd call the French-sounding celestes, but nonetheless they had strings and beautiful flutes, of which this organ has a plenty. So this is the Adagio in D-flat. Feinenklagen variations are, of course, are based on a part of a Bach cantata, a bass line. You may be able to hum it when you get through with it. It's in every measure. What the glorious thing about this is it ends with Was Gott tut, or Was Gott gottetan, I forgot the German exactly, but it's what God ordains is always good. And so after the crying and the sorrowing, Bach used that chorale, and so did Liszt. And so Liszt, in a way, commented or parodied the entire cantata from ending with this nice chorale. It'll be very obvious when it comes in. It's from the minor mode, we go to F major, and it's really a rather glorious and simple ending. Liszt didn't write a lot of church music, per se, in his lifetime, but later in his life, when he took orders in the Roman Catholic faith, he did write some small masses and music that could be used in worship services, whereby they would be rather slow and ponderous to our ears today. This piece, being a concert piece, still has lots of interest and also is very rhapsodic. So in the middle of the piece, even though there's this lovely decoration of it, it becomes very rhapsodic and very melancholy, you might say. The whole piece is that way, except for the ending. So this is quite an extensive work. It's the Liszt's second longest organ work. You're hearing all the major Liszt organ works today, so you've been to class and you've passed. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is a wonderful story about St. Francis of Paula. We've already heard, or probably are familiar with St. Francis of Assisi, but St. Francis of Paula gained his fame on the sea because he threw his cloak down on the sea, put his staff on it, and went to Sicily. Now, I don't know how true it is. It's one of the legends. As you can see, it's from the two legends. But I hope you all have good sea legs and nobody gets seasick. Once in a while, I get seasick. You can feel the ocean on this piece. As you can imagine, there is a storm that crops up. And he does rebuke the storm. That'll be very obvious. And then he triumphantly lands in Sicily. But here's the catch, ahead of the boat. Didn't I write the story in there? Yes, he was refused on the boat, but he got there before the boat got there. So anyway, he made quite a journey. And this is a piano piece. So it's a transcription for the organ by the famous Swiss organist, Lionel Rogue. And I've heard it played only once, besides myself. And it's really quite an exciting piece. And on the piano, of course, it's very florid. And then the organ, it has some of those same characteristics, but it's kind of fun because the piano can't do the grandioso effects that the organ has. So it's a fun piece, so grip hard. Thank you. probably all know that harmonies du soir means sounds of the evening. It's another piano piece that is very gentle. And I'm starting it on the back organ and ending it on the back organ. It would have that kind of peaceful completeness. You never know how you can figure these things out. But once I heard the antiphonal organ, I said to myself, I was trying to do everything up here. And you have to kind of weigh your issues of what stops you're using. And then I said, And then I put on the back organ again and said, ah. So it's a very sweet little piece. It has some little noise in the middle, but very sweet. I'll go right from that into the ad nos, which I said, list the revolutionary. He is, indeed. At this time, in 1850, when he heard the opera Le Prophète and heard the chant of the Anabaptists in the opera about longing to go to the waters of baptism and so forth, and it was also a call to revolution in this opera. And Liszt enjoyed that melody so much, he wrote this was his first organ piece, and it is his longest. It was the longest organ piece written in history at that time. So it's almost like a little symphony in one movement, but it's a grand piece. It really is grand. Thank you.